Hello everyone. I created a digital camera with STM32 Discovery board. So I'd like to introduce it in this video. This is the camera I created. This is the front side, and the camera module is mounted here. On the back side, you can see 3.2-inch display, and buttons and dial for control is on the right side. On the edge, there is a USB cable connector, so you can supply power from USB charger like this. And finally, the SD card slot is here. Then, let's turn on the power by connecting USB cable. Now you can see live view image. Now I'm shaking my hand. I think responsivity is pretty nice and FPS is nicely fast. Now let's take some photos. I need some objects. So one is pretty colorful one so that I can check the color later. And the other one should be here. So, I'm taking a photo of the left object first. Now you can see color is displayed appropriately. I mean, red is red, yellow is yellow. And by pushing this button, you can take a photo. And I'm taking the other one. As you can see, due to narrow FOV, it looks like this. So anyway, I got two photos now. Then by pushing the buttons, right bottom, it enters playback mode, and you can see the picture. And by rotating the dial, the next content is displayed. Then I move to recording mode again. And as for this dial, usually cameras on the market, this kind of dial is used to change camera settings, such as ISO and shutter speed. However, this camera module, it does not have iris, so F number is fixed. As for gain, I mean ISO and shutter speed, this camera module takes care of AGC and auto exposure control. So I don't need to control these stuff. And there's nothing to do with this dial. So in this project, I assigned JPEG encode quality setting to this dial. So when I rotate this dial, a blue bar appears. And when it goes to left, JPEG quality is low. So then I take a picture with this setting, I mean low quality. And then I set the JPEG encode quality as high. Take another one. So let's see the differences. Move to playback mode. So this is the photo I took with low quality. So this is very noisy, I mean dirty, and you can see even macro block. And this is a photo with high quality. I think it's pretty okay. So anyway, you can use this dial like this. And finally, I'd like to introduce function is you can take movie as well. There is a dial in the middle. And actually you can push this dial. And by pushing this dial and button, you can start movie record. During movie recording, FPS becomes slow due to heavy CPU load. FPS is around 5 FPS. Anyway, I'm recording movie right now. I think it's almost enough. So, by pushing this button again, movie record is finished. And move back to playback mode. by pushing button and skip previous contents. Oh yes, this is a movie I recorded. So now you can see the movie I recorded earlier. And while I'm playing movie, I can pause it by pushing the button. And by pushing the button again, I can restart movie. And pause, and play, and pause, and play. And when it reaches the end of contents, movie play stops. So as you saw, you can capture still photo and record movie and play them in this camera. And this content is recorded as JPEG and Motion JPEG format. And since they are common formats, the content saved in the SD card must be played in PC. So let's check them. So in my desktop PC, I inserted the SD card here. And in my SD card, I can find 4 JPEG files and 1 movie file here. So I open a JPEG file, this one, and this is the first photo, and second one, and the third one, and it was with low JPEG quality. So the size is very small. However, image is very noisy, of course. And this is the fourth image with high quality. So the file size is a little big. And the last content is, this one is the movie file of Motion JPEG. So as you think, I can play it in a normal movie player in my PC, but this Motion JPEG format does not contain FPS information. So play speed depends on player application. So it looks like fast forward play, like this. So anyway, I can play these contents in my PC because the contents created in camera is very common format. So then I'd like to play the content created in PC in my camera. So I don't need them anymore. So I delete them. And now I create some new JPEG file in my PC. The first size image is 320 by 240. So I draw something randomly and save it to the SD card as JPEG file and named it test01.jpg. And this is the JPEG I created now. By the way, for playback mode, the camera can play a variety of size, whether it's small or big. So next, I create a big landscape image like this and draw something. And save it as test02.jpg. And next, I create portrait image like this. And save it as test03. And now I have 3 contents in total. And next, I'm making movie file. And I downloaded a free movie content from the internet. And I think it is easy to check color. But my camera is not as powerful to decode MP4 file. So I convert this MP4 file into Motion JPEG. To do this, I need some command works. First, I need to populate JPEG files from this MP4 frame by frame. To do this, I use FFmpeg. First, I create the folder to contain these JPEG files. Name it temp. And I run FFmpeg. And this is the input file name. And the camera can play movie up to 10 FPS. So I set FPS as 10 FPS. Also, as I mentioned, the camera can decode big image, but when the camera resizes the image, it takes time. So I make the image, I make the small size. So I use the same size as display, 320 by 240. And the output file should be like this. It should be VEF, not VR. And done. So now I got a bunch of JPEG files in this folder, like this. So actually, a Motion JPEG is a file which combining these JPEG files. So I use command again. I use copy command. I do copy in binary mode. And I copy all the JPEG files in the temp folder to one AVI file. And done. And these JPEG files is combined to this one AVI file. So I don't need these files anymore. So delete them. So now let's play these contents in the camera. So this is the SD card containing the contents, and turn the power on. So, enter the movie, playback mode. And this is the first created JPEG file, and the second one. So, as you remember, it was a big image. And when I open a big image, the image is automatically adjusted, whether it is landscape or portrait image. And next one is the movie file. It was the Motion JPEG movie, and it was played. The first content, second, the third, and movie. At the end, I'd like to summarize the specification of my camera. It can capture still photo as a JPEG format, and the maximum, the size is 320 by 240. Also, I can record movie as a Motion JPEG format. The size is the same as JPEG, but the maximum FPS is 5 FPS. In playback mode, you can play JPEG file. And as for JPEG file, in addition to the contents captured in the camera itself, you can play JPEG file created in another device, such as PC, and the maximum size is around 2.5K and 2K. And actually, I didn't show it this time, but I can play RGB 565 format, which is a similar format as bitmap. And as for movie, frame rate is around 10 FPS. And these contents can be stored in SD card with FAT32 format. So this is it, and you can find source code in my GitHub here. And along with source code, you can find another document such as software design and hardware design documents as well. So if you are interested, please check them. Thank you for watching. Bye.